this might become our best telescope. What if I told you there exists a telescope so extraordinary that it has the power to completely revolutionize not just one, but multiple fields of scientific study? Prepare to have your mind blown by the remarkable capabilities of the Vera Rubin Observatory. Not only will this groundbreaking telescope delve into the depths of extragalactic and solar system science, but it also holds the potential to unveil the mysteries of gravitational waves and even discover evidence of alien life. Picture a device that can accomplish all of these awe-inspiring feats simultaneously. But wait, there's more. Brace yourselves for the mind-boggling statistic that the Vera Rubin Observatory has the ability to detect an astonishing 10 million astronomical events in just a single night. Now imagine this mind-blowing mission is slated to last an entire decade. Can you fathom the sheer volume of data that future astronomers will grapple with? It's mind-blowing. The reasons above might already be enough to make it our best telescope, yet the story doesn't end there. Talented engineers are toiling away to ensure that each new revelation is accessible within a mere 60 seconds of detection, making it instantly available to the public. Just imagine, while you've been listening to this introduction, a plethora of groundbreaking astronomical data has already become accessible to one and all. Talk about Vera Rubin. So just to start, Vera Rubin was an American astronomer known for her groundbreaking work on galaxy rotation rates. She was so smart, she noticed the galaxies were rotating much faster than expected based on their visible mass. This soon led to the realization that there must be a significant amount of unseen mass holding them together. This phenomenon, known as the galaxy rotation problem, led to the development of the theory of dark matter. Dark matter is still not fully understood, but one thing we know for sure, its presence is crucial for understanding the future of the universe. Rubin was also a pioneer for women's rights. She was the first woman allowed to use the instruments at the Palomar Observatory, and has made significant contributions to the study of galactic and extragalactic dynamics. Despite her groundbreaking work, Rubin expressed disappointment that her findings did not support modifications to Newton's laws of gravitation. No wonder such a great telescope will be named after such a brilliant mind. Capability of the telescope. Now let's dive into something truly captivating. How does the Vera Rubin telescope stack up against other renowned observatories scattered across the world? Upon completion, the Vera Rubin telescope will secure its place as the 7th largest telescope globally, boasting an impressive effective aperture of 8.4 meters, surpassing the venerable 8.2 meter VLT and Subaru telescopes. It will undoubtedly make its mark. Just like its counterparts, this extraordinary instrument will be stationed in the exceptional astronomical haven of Chile, renowned for its unparalleled stargazing conditions. However, the Vera Rubin telescope marvels don't stop there. Strikingly, it embraces a compact and short design, offering unparalleled agility. Consider this intriguing scenario. Which telescope do you think would move and pinpoint different points in the sky faster? A colossal one or a compact counterpart? The answer lies with the Vera Rubin telescope, a stiff and short telescope equipped with a 3.2 gigapixel digital camera. This technological marvel will capture a 15-second exposure every 20 seconds and repoint within a mere 5 seconds. Its ability to traverse the celestial expanse with astonishing swiftness is nothing short of mind-blowing. Nestled strategically in the southern hemisphere, the Vera Rubin telescope's position grants it the opportunity to survey the entire southern sky with an astounding 3-day span. This extraordinary feat will be replicated for a 10-year duration, assuming all goes according to plan. With each passing moment, this telescope will constantly unravel the mysteries of the heavens, contributing to the ever-expanding breadth of astronomical knowledge. The name. The Vera Rubin Observatory, previously known as LSST, has a rich history rooted in the exploration of the cosmos. Before the dawn of 2020, LSST stood for Legacy Survey of Space and Time, a a fitting name for an observatory that would continue the tradition of sky surveys. Throughout the ages, astronomers have tirelessly compiled catalogs of celestial wonders, starting with visually compiled lists like the famous Messier catalog in the 18th century. As technology advanced, photographic surveys took over, with notable collections like the Harvard Plate Collection and the National Geographic Society. Palomar Observatory Sky Survey captivating astronomers' imaginations. However, the digital revolution eventually superseded the need for photographic plates. Enter the Sloan Digital Sky Survey, SDSS, in the early 2000s, which marked a groundbreaking shift in the way astronomers accessed and studied the vast amounts of data available. These surveys, from the antiquated catalogs to the modern digital platforms, serve as essential legacies for future generations of stargazers. This observatory, with its storied past and cutting-edge technology, is poised to continue this legacy, offering astronomers unparalleled opportunities to explore and unravel the mysteries of the universe. Let me show you what this telescope will be capable of. Let's talk about some numbers. Doubling the asteroid findings. Imagine this. For a whole century, astronomers have been tirelessly searching the vast expanse of the solar system, seeking out elusive and minuscule objects. Their goal? To meticulously categorize and predict the orbits of these celestial wonders. Some were easier to locate than others, while the existence of certain objects remained merely theoretical, their presence never confirmed. Enter the Vera Rubin telescope, armed and ready to seek out asteroids, dusty rocks, and Kuiper Belt objects that lazily drift through the cosmos. In just its inaugural year of operation, this remarkable instrument will double the number of these small inhabitants within our solar system. Astounding, isn't it? After a century of pursuit, astronomers are on the cusp of uncovering a wealth of hidden treasures in a mere matter of months. Nowhere to hide, little objects. This extraordinary revelation holds immeasurable significance. Consider, for instance, the implications it has for the possible existence of a mysterious ninth planet. Its concealment will prove to be an arduous feat indeed, even if it's cold, small, and faint. Even our beloved Pluto, though challenging to detect now, will soon become laughably easy to spot. Gravitational waves. But let us not forget the far-reaching capabilities of this telescope. Its applications extend far beyond the realm of unearthing small objects. It has the potential to revolutionize our understanding of gravitational waves. Picture this. When supernovae explode or when black holes and neutron stars collide, these waves ripple through space, leaving in their wake a captivating mystery. Currently, detectors like LIGO and Virgo provide only a rough estimation of where these gravitational waves originate. We desperately need a telescope that can survey an entire quadrant of the sky, capturing even the faintest glimmers, in order to unravel the secrets behind their birth. And speed is of the essence, my friends. Enter the Vera Rubin telescope, the perfect contender for this weighty task. In a world where the unknown beckons, the Vera Rubin telescope stands tall, ready to illuminate the enigmatic corners of our universe. Hey, if you're still watching the video, it means you're really enjoying it. Don't forget to like the video and hit the notification bell so that we can improve our videos for you, the viewer. Mapping the universe. The James Webb Space Telescope is our best telescope right now. It can see in infrared light, but it can only see a small area of the sky. It's not good for making maps of galaxies and quasars in the universe. It would take a really long time to do that. But LSST is different. It can see really far away. It can see back to when the universe was very young. We can use LSST to make a map of where the galaxies were when the universe was only a few hundred thousand years old. This will help us understand how the universe is getting bigger and maybe even how it started. And LSST can do a lot more than that. It can help us find new comets and asteroids. It can help us study the Milky Way and all its stars. We can even learn about the galaxies that are closest to us and the ones that are the farthest away. It's like a one-stop shop for all of our space questions. Spotting supernovae. Astronomers have been looking for supernovae for a long time. They found about 1,500 of them. But with the Vera Rubin telescope, they think they can find a million. And these supernovae are really important. They can help us understand how the universe is expanding. Scientists like Hubble figured out that supernova explosions in faraway galaxies are the best way to learn about this. So with LSST and the Vera Rubin telescope, we're going to learn a lot about the universe. We'll be able to make maps of galaxies when the universe is young. We'll find lots of supernovae to help us understand how the universe is getting bigger. It's an exciting time for space exploration. The use of AI. The LSST telescope is a remarkable piece of engineering that will change the way we do astronomy forever. Every night, it will detect and record an astonishing 10 million explosive, moving, or changing objects, all of which will be flagged and published online within just 60 seconds. This overwhelming number of discoveries presents a significant challenge in deciding which objects are the most interesting and deserving of further study. To request permission to study a new astronomical event with other big telescopes, scientists must be confident that their discovery is truly important and worth the time and resources. Therefore, the engineers at LSST work tirelessly to ensure that the telescope has the capability to identify and prioritize the most significant objects among the millions detected each night. This task of selecting the most promising objects for further study is far from easy. To overcome this challenge, the engineers have been using simulation to understand how quickly they can identify the rarest supernovae or transient events. For example, they seek to determine how rapidly they can locate and track the most elusive transient event and link it to a moving object, such as a comet. Achieving this level of precision and efficiency is a daunting task. Fortunately, artificial intelligence and machine learning come to the rescue. These advanced technologies play a crucial role in analyzing the massive amount of data collected by the telescope, identifying patterns and making intelligent decisions about which objects warrant further investigation. By leveraging AI and machine learning, the LSST telescope can effectively sift through the deluge of nightly discoveries and pinpoint the most valuable and scientifically significant objects for in-depth study. This is only one of the ways AI will help us in the years to come. And by the way, if you want to know more about it, consider watching our recent video about how AI will change your future. The power of a public legacy. The importance of an available public legacy cannot be overstated. It is a treasure trove of information that can be accessed by anyone, and it holds immense potential for future discoveries and advancements. Imagine a scenario where someone stumbles upon this vast reservoir of knowledge, armed with a more ingenious idea on how to process the data. They could revolutionize the way we understand and interpret this information. This concept is not new. Scientists have long understood the value of preserving data for future exploration. Consider the Apollo samples that were painstakingly collected and brought back to Earth. Rather than exhaustively studying and depleting these samples, some were preserved untouched. This was a strategic decision by NASA, an investment for the future. These perfectly preserved samples are like time capsules waiting to be opened and analyzed with more advanced technologies yet to be developed. In 2019, after more than four decades, scientists finally opened one such pristine rock and soil sample from the moon, brought back during the Apollo 17 mission. This breakthrough marked an extraordinary moment, as it allowed scientists to practice techniques that will be vital for studying future samples collected during the Artemis missions. The ability to revisit and study these preserved samples with enhanced analytical technologies is an incredible opportunity for groundbreaking discoveries. Now let's imagine the possibilities if this concept were applied on a broader scale. What if all data, all information were collected and stored indefinitely accessible to anyone? This would enable future researchers armed with better tools and a fresh perspective to reanalyze and reinterpret this wealth of knowledge. They could uncover hidden patterns, make new connections, and even stumble upon discoveries that were previously overlooked by their predecessors. The importance of a public legacy cannot be emphasized enough. This is what Vera Rubin ultimately is, a testament to our curiosity, our drive for knowledge, and our commitment to progress. By preserving data, by making it available to everyone, we ensure that it is not lost or forgotten. Instead, we provide a foundation upon which future generations can build and expand, armed with their own unique insights and insane curiosity. That's all for this video. Thanks for joining us. What are your thoughts about the Vera Rubin Telescope? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.